Hi guys, this what you see is a 12 volts to 220 volts computer UPS inverter. At the back you can see three sockets and the capacity is up to 600 VA. The two thick wires that you see are to feed the DC input 12 volts 7 amps to this Luminous Duo inverter. Let's open it up to confirm if this UPS is working fine and also identify the polarity of the 12 volts DC input cables, because they look alike and it's difficult to differentiate which one is positive and negative. Although if you look closely, you will find one of the terminal is covered with black tape indicating a negative terminal and the other one will automatically become positive. Now let's test this UPS with this 12 volts 5 amps DC supply to further confirm that it is working. The non-insulated terminal is always negative and the other one automatically becomes positive. After connecting it carefully to the terminals of the UPS, you should hear a beeping sound, and then turn the UPS on, the light will glow. And for the final check, you will have to test the socket output voltage, which here as you can see is 170 volts AC, finally indicating that the inverter is perfectly fine. Let's cover the positive terminal with a red tape to avoid any future mistakes and place everything back as it was before. As you saw guys, the DC input terminals are very small, so to make it easier to connect it to the battery, we will have to extend the DC input cables. Here I'm using the blue one as positive and black as negative. For extension cables, I would recommend that you use at least 8mm to 10mm wires, although here I'm using only 4mm cables because I don't have those. And this UPS is going to draw huge current depending on the load that is connected. Now comes the clips that are needed to be connected to the extension cables. The clips are to be as big as possible so that they can withstand huge currents without getting heated up, and it is highly recommended that they are of copper, although I am sticking to the old iron ones because I don't have those. This is a 12 volts 150Ah discarded inverter battery. It has been used for 5 years, continuous charge and discharge, but when I checked its voltage, it still had some juice present. You can see that it is indicating 12.25 volts. Let's test this UPS with this battery. The beep indicates that the connection has been established. Let's turn it on. The amps taken by my workshop lights are somewhere around 1.25 amps. So that is what I'm going to need from this UPS to run it under light out condition, which I think should be easy for this to handle. This is the mains plug to turn my workshop lights on, all of them. So when I'm going to disconnect it, as you saw that they turned off. Now let's connect this plug to the socket output of the UPS and check if it can handle all of my lab lights. Socket has been placed. Let's turn it on. Let's press the switch. As you saw that the lights glow for a second and then it started indicating low battery. Because the terminal is all corroded, so I think that the connection between the clip and the terminal is not established correctly. So after properly placing it again, I'm giving it a second try. And now you can see that it's lighting up perfectly, with the hope that it continues to work for longer period of time, because obviously I will have to work for 5 or 6 hours. Although I also have to talk about the charging of the battery, which I will cover later in the video. This is an induction fan, 25 watts. Those are 450 watts halogens, that's the working area, and those are 420 watts LED tube lights, including one 35 watts focus LED. Now let's do the battery amps measurement. The amps drawn are as high as 32 amperes, which is quite high for the 4mm wire cables, and that is exactly why I recommended thicker cables up to 8mm or 10mm. There is one more thing that you need to make sure, which is keeping the batteries on some wooden or plastic platform, which will further reduce self-discharging of the battery. Now comes the part of charging the battery, for which I am going to use this 15 volts 3 amperes laptop charger. It already has clips attached with positive and negative. Although the output voltage is still a little high, which is 15 volts, and the required voltage is somewhere around 14 to 14.5 volts for battery charging. So we will have to reduce the output voltage with the help of a 6 amperes diode. The black colored side terminal is the positive one, which is to be connected to the negative terminal of the battery with the negative terminal of the DC input terminals of the UPS. And to the negative terminal of the diode that I am bending at present, we have to connect the negative from the charger. This will also prevent reverse discharging. The positive will be directly connected to the positive terminal of the battery. Now guys, I have already switched on the charger and thus the charging has already started. So it's time to measure the current that is being fed to the battery with the help of the charger, which as you can see is around 4 amperes. That is quite good. And also I have added these thick 4 mm blue cables, which are coming out from my bicycle generator that I made a few months back. So now I'm going to exercise and that energy is again going to get stored in my inverter battery. You can see that at present I'm feeding somewhere around 50 watts and I did a max of 160 watts, the result of which can be seen here as the increase in voltage from 12.25 to 12.48 volts DC. Okay, so guys, now comes the hidden question for today. Why is it that only the positive terminal of the battery gets corroded? Do check out my previous water pump video. Its link is provided in the description. It works great and is made from simple discarded stuff. The operating voltage is only 12 volts and the output pressure is superb. Did you know that the first water pump was invented by a Russian engineer V.A. Poshechikov in 1899?